Jojo's in trouble.
Somebody stuck me in.
Who could have?
I wanted to give you an opportunity to set yourself up.
It's important you be there.
I'm going to go and see him. I will, I'm going to see him.
What?
He's going to kill me.
She's my daughter.
Now Jojo's back in action.
Well, the time is now. I can make thousands selling a wee bit of powder, then we can go to London.
But things have changed.
Drugs! That's what's got us now. You should be out there fighting!
What are your chances in your life, eh? You have to take them.
He's playing a very dangerous game. Looking After Jojo, Monday at 9 on BBC Two.
Biglietti, biglietti, prego. Biglietto, signore.
What would you say to this man?
Ah, ma lei che cosa fa su questo treno? Ma non capisce.
How would you answer this woman?
Excusez-moi, nous sommes déjà vus, non? Que faites-vous ici?
And how would you respond to these men? If you're lost for words, BBC Learning Zone can help you learn a language. There's currently a season of programs and courses for you to record overnight. A week of beginner's Spanish starts Monday morning at 4 a.m. So remember to set your video on Sunday night.
Never listen to the man behind the mic. Now on BBC Two, a radio celebrity finds his life spiralling out of control and his language is going the same way in tonight's film. Jeff Bridges and Robin Williams star in The Fisher King.
My car!
For the BBC Two Comedy Zone.
I've just spent a month's salary on Liberace's bedspread.
Be calm.
What sets of legs has that man got?
Am I in paradise?
You're all right. It's England.
Help me, I'm trapped.
Watch out for the Blackadder. Get friendly with the Friday Night Armistice and try the Game On move. Friday from 9 on BBC Two.
Fantastic evening!
But you know how you're always on at me to get you a pet?
Yes.
Well, I got one.
It's a cow.
Actually, Daisy is a mad cow. Come and play with the cow. Come on. Go. Fetch, please, fetch.
Find out what happened to Daisy in Goodness Gracious Me, Monday at 10 on BBC Two.
An extra pair of socks under the duvet tonight. David Braine has the weather details.
Hello again, and welcome to Weatherview. For those who have friends and relatives on the other side of the world, I'm going to start with Australia and New Zealand because we're keeping a very close eye on a tropical cyclone that's been developing in the Coral Sea. It's this curl of cloud you see on the satellite sequence here getting closer and closer to that northwestern coast of Queensland, Australia. And in fact, Katrina is potentially pretty strong. It's got sustained winds of 140, 150 kilometres an hour and with some quite strong gusts as well. Heavy rain getting in just to the south of Cairns. It looks like it'll make landfall over the next 12 to 15 hours. Further south, we do have a large area of high pressure. So, of course, it's summer in the southern hemisphere. So some quite high temperatures into Adelaide and also further eastwards. But some showers developing on this area of low pressure as we move through Tuesday and Wednesday. Well, let's get closer to home. Of course, it's winter in the northern hemisphere and it's certainly getting colder. Quite a dramatic change in temperatures on the western side of Europe. This low pressure sweeping through the British Isles for Sunday and Monday then pushes southwards, and as it does so, it starts to pull in these northeasterly winds, and that means a real change to lower temperatures. As I run the sequence, the temperature charts, you'll see the blues invading, and those blues, they represent daytime temperatures below freezing, getting into that far northern and northeastern tip of Spain, but over much of northern Europe, including the British Isles, we are going to see those daytime temperatures fairly close to freezing. And during the nighttime, it's going to get well frosty. In fact, we're going to see quite a widespread frost for the whole of the British Isles on the next few nights, especially Monday night, Tuesday night, before it starts to warm up as we move through Wednesday and Thursday. For tonight, the frost is mostly in the far north, -1 in parts of Scotland, -3 in the Northern Isles. Elsewhere, no trouble with frost. A lot of cloud and some rain, and the potential for further snowfall across the northern parts of Scotland. In fact, north of the Forth Clyde Valley, we're going to see more snow both tonight and tomorrow, and the potential for some pretty nasty conditions as the winds freshen. There could even be some blizzards and some very difficult driving conditions because of that snow. Now, through Sunday, we see the area of low pressure sweep across the British Isles, a spell of wet and windy weather. And as it moves its way eastwards, it pulls in those northerly winds. That's a cold wind coming down, bringing some snow down those eastern counties of both England and Scotland, and those winds reaching gale force at times through the North Sea. For Sunday's forecast, then, we're going to see a spell of wet weather for central parts of the British Isles, and there could be some local flooding, more snow for Scotland, showers following in behind in southern counties of England and Wales, and quite cold as well. Temperatures at best around 5 or 6 degrees, but feeling bitterly cold in the breeze. And then through Monday and Tuesday, once we start to see that northerly wind develop, it's going to get even colder, with snow showers for eastern Scotland, the northeast of England, and even as far south as Kent and Essex. We could see one or two snow showers as we move through Monday and Tuesday. Bye for now.
Tomorrow, the Animal Zone takes you to
the most exciting group of islands in the whole world. The Galapagos.
Where birds have never taken flight. Giant tortoises roam in the mists, and dragons live among the fires of the most active volcanoes on the earth. Journey to the land that time forgot in the Animal Zone. Tomorrow at 5:25 on BBC Two.
Biglietti, biglietti prego. Biglietto signore.
What would you say to this man?
Ah, ma lei che cosa fa su questo treno? Ma non capisce.
How would you answer this woman?
Excusez-moi, nous sommes déjà vus, non? Que faites-vous ici?
And how would you respond to these men? If you're lost for words, BBC Learning Zone can help you learn a language. There's currently a season of programs and courses for you to record overnight. A week of beginner's Spanish starts Monday morning at 4 a.m. So remember to set your video on Sunday night.
And BBC Learning Zone brings education through the night from 3 o'clock here on BBC Two.
We'll be right back. Welcome to BBC Learning Zone here on BBC Two. Now it's time for some GCSE bite-size revision. This programme covers key elements of the maths curriculum, focusing on using numbers, percentages and proportion, measure and shape, and space.